The special thing about products that flow is that they are consumed in large quantities and at a huge, fast pace. So you get a lot of them everywhere. And it's a difficult challenge to collect that from everywhere. And the value is relatively low. So you have to find ways by a collective system to get money available to organize this. But at the end, the whole society is better if we organize this in a better way. For the designer, I think it also has some consequences because you have to design your product and packaging to be part of such a circular system. So you always have to check first, can I make a product last longer? You can make a reusable bottle or wash your coffee cup. But there are certain situations where you need products with a short lifetime, and that's inevitable. So you have to make a design which fits that situation. Products that flow need a different approach than long-lasting products because due to the situation, it's not possible to use a certain product for a long period. For example, food, you just eat and then it's gone, so you cannot use it for a very long period. Same for the packaging around it. You know upfront that it will be used only for a very short period. So you have to design the product or the packaging also for in a circular way. The first design strategy we call rethink, and that's about asking yourself the question, why are we doing this? Why do we use this packaging? Why are we using disposables? And it's always, there are always good reasons to do so, but asking yourself the question might lead up to new solutions, which might come to some solution which will have no waste at all. Now, the second one is reuse, and that's about making packaging reusable, like a bottle. You can refill a bottle, use it again and again and again. And that saves, of course, a lot of waste if you can do that. But you have to organize a system to do that. It's not only about the packaging, but also in combination with the system. Well, the third one, recycling, is of course something very obvious. We have to, every waste that is available, we have to recycle in the future. But what a lot of designers and companies forgetting is that they also have to reuse recycled content upfront in their own packaging, because you can recycle something and somebody else has to solve it, but you also have to use recycled content yourself. Yeah, the last one is called Renew, and that's also both about using bio-based content like paper, carton, bioplastics, maybe natural fibers to make a packaging. And on the other side, also about maybe recycling it again or making it biodegradable and give it back to nature. When to apply which strategy is really a difficult question, because it's always depending on the product, which kind of product or packaging you're using, the kind of application. Maybe also the client is an important factor. Not every client is able to make a reusable system happen. So sometimes you will have to make something which will be recycled. So it's depending on a lot of different factors, and that's also a nice challenge for the designers, I think.